Assalamu alaikum. Today, we will be talking about Dr. Gary Miller, a renowned mathematician and theologian. He was active in Christian missionary work at a particular point of his life, but he soon began to discover many inconsistencies in the Bible. Eventually, he decided to read the Qur'an, expecting that it, too, would contain a mixture of truth and falsehood. He discovered, to his amazement, that the message of the Qur'an was precisely the same as the essence of truth that he had distilled from the Bible. He became a Muslim, and since then has been active in giving public presentations on Islam, including appearances on radio and television. He is also the author of several articles and publications about Islam. Dr. Miller claims that the key to avoiding the endless dissatisfaction in our lives is to satisfy ourselves about standards first. To satisfy ourselves with a list of criteria that constitute satisfying proof, and then test the things that we examine. I will apply this to the Qur'an in particular. Ask a thoughtful Christian why he is Christian, and he will usually reply with the miracle of resurrection. The basis for his belief is that about 2,000 years ago, a man died and he was raised from the dead. That is his miracle, his touchstone, because all else depends on that. Ask a Muslim, well, what is your miracle? Why are you a Muslim? Where is your miracle? And the Muslim can go over and take his miracle off the shelf and hand it to you, because his miracle is still with us today. This miracle is the Qur'an, and it is our touchstone. Professor Miller has even recorded his amazement in the book, calling it the amazing Qur'an. He says that calling the Qur'an amazing is not something done only by Muslims, who have an appreciation for the book and who are pleased with it. It has been labeled amazing by non-Muslims as well. In fact, even people who hate Islam have called it amazing. Dr. Gary Miller says that no author in the world has the courage to claim that they have written a book free of errors. But the Qur'an says, on the contrary, that it has no error and even challenges the readers to find errors. Miller's writings were fair and his study and comments were positive, even better than many of the Muslims would write about the Noble Qur'an. He considered the Noble Qur'an, as it should be, and reached the conclusion that it could not be the work of a human being. The first surprising issue for Professor Miller was the challenging tone in many verses of the Qur'an, such as the verses that can be translated as, "Will they not contemplate the Qur'an? And if it had been from anywhere other than the providence of Allah, indeed they would have found in it many differences." Although Professor Miller was skeptical at first, he was astonished at what he found. There is no human author who would write a book and challenge others to prove that it is not errorless. As for the Noble Qur'an, it tells the reader that there are no errors in it, and then challenges all people to find a single mistake. The Noble Qur'an does not mention the hard events in Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam's personal life, such as the death of his dear wife Lady Khadija radiallahu anha, and the death of his daughters and sons. Interestingly, the verses that were revealed as a comment on some of the setbacks proclaimed victory, while those revealed at times of victory warned against arrogance and called for more sacrifices and efforts. If one wrote their own autobiography, they would magnify the victories and justify the defeats. The Noble Qur'an did the opposite, and this is consistent and logical. It was not a history of a specific period, but rather a text that sets general rules for the relationship between Allah, the Almighty, and worshippers. There is a surah in the Noble Qur'an called Maryam, in which Lady Maryam, radiallahu anha, is eulogized in a way not even found in the Bible. At the same time, there is no surah in the name of Lady Aisha, radiallahu anha, or Lady Fatima, radiallahu anha. The name of Prophet Isa, alayhi salam, is mentioned 25 times in the Noble Qur'an, while the name of Prophet Muhammad, sallallahu alayhi wasallam, is mentioned only 5 times. Some people say that the devils used to dictate to Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam what to write in the Noble Qur'an. But the question is, how could this be while it contains verses that can be translated as, "And the devils have not brought the revelation down, it is not allowable for them, nor would they be able." And, "So when you recite the Qur'an, first seek refuge in Allah from Satan, the expelled, from his mercy." If you are in the same situation as the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, while he and Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu were inside the Kaaba of Hira, surrounded by the unbelievers who could have seen them if they had looked down, your first reaction would probably be to search for a back exit or some other way out, or to remain silent in order not to be heard. However, The Prophet ﷺ told Abu Bakr radiallahu anhu, "Grieve not, surely Allah is with us." This is not the mentality of a deceiver. It is the mentality of a prophet who has the confidence that Allah, the Almighty, would surely take care of him. Surat al-Masad was revealed 10 years before the death of Abu Lahab, the Prophet's uncle. He had 10 complete years to prove that the noble Qur'an was wrong. However, he did not believe or even pretend to believe. How could the Prophet ﷺ be that confident unless he was sure that the noble Qur'an was Allah's revelation? In 1977, Professor Miller participated in a famous debate with Islamic preacher Ahmad Didat. His logic was clear and his justification seemed based on intent to reach the truth without pride or prejudice. Many wished at the time that this man would embrace Islam. In 1978, Professor Miller embraced Islam and called himself Abdul Ahad. He worked for some years at Oil and Minerals University in Saudi Arabia and then devoted his life to Dawah through TV programs and public lectures. The lesson here is to think past your biases, which pull you away from the right path. May Allah keep us all on the right path. Ameen.